Have you been told that you have unexplained infertility? What does that mean? Is it possible that you might really have a problem which was missed, such as endometriosis? Stay tuned. Couples who have had difficulty becoming pregnant will hopefully see a fertility specialist like me for some basic diagnostic testing. This includes a variety of tests for the female, including blood tests, ultrasounds, and x-ray tests. For the male, a sperm test is performed. For those couples who complete all of that testing but do not find any abnormalities, we have a special name, unexplained infertility. Studies have found that 15 to 30% of couples with infertility may ultimately end up with this diagnosis. Endometriosis is a problem in which the tissue which normally grows inside the uterine cavity instead grows outside of the uterus, most commonly in the abdomen and pelvis. People can have varying levels of endometriosis. There are various staging systems for endometriosis. The most common one has four levels: minimal, mild, moderate, and severe. People with moderate or severe endometriosis could be identified with tools like ultrasound or an MRI. People with minimal or mild endometriosis could typically not be identified in this way. In the past, it was more common for doctors to also perform surgery on a female who presented with infertility, especially those with otherwise unexplained infertility. This type of surgery, called laparoscopy, would enable the diagnosis of minimal or mild endometriosis. More recently, however, performing laparoscopy has become far less common. There are multiple reasons for this. First, of course, is that it's far more invasive. This is a surgery which requires anesthesia and incisions in the abdomen. Second is the cost. Laparoscopy is a costly option. Also, the resolution of ultrasound machines has improved and MRIs are more readily available, so that presumably would allow less cases to be missed. Recently, researchers did an analysis looking at all of the studies they could find in which people with unexplained infertility had a laparoscopy. Ultimately, about a dozen studies were included in the analysis. In total, this included over 1,700 patients with unexplained infertility. Amazingly, 44% were found to have some amount of endometriosis. 3/4 of those were minimal or mild. The others were moderate to severe, which frankly should have been identified even before surgery was performed. These cases of moderate to severe endometriosis were seen even in the most recent studies, which presumably had the best ultrasounds and MRI machines. There is new technology emerging that should improve our ability to diagnose endometriosis more easily. I talk about that in this video. You could also argue that it may not be critical to identify people with minimal or mild endometriosis, since other fertility treatments like IVF may work just as well for them as with people without endometriosis. Until less invasive methods for diagnosing endometriosis are validated and commonly available, it is not unreasonable to have laparoscopy if you've been told you have unexplained infertility. Infertility TV is your most trusted source for accurate information on infertility and miscarriage. If you are not a subscriber yet, hit the subscribe button right now. A new episode is released every week. Don't miss any episodes. You can also check us out on our website, ivf1.com, where you can become a patient.